July 29, 1968 was a dark day for Costa Rica as the nation experienced its second deadliest natural disaster in recorded history. Without much warning, a growing cryptodome or very shallow magmatic intrusion that formed the shape of a dome and uplifted overlying rock just west of the towering Arenal Volcano's summit burst, releasing a lateral blast which both ejected thousands of tons worth of large lava bombs in a 4,500-meter radius and released superheated pyroclastic flows. These pyroclastic flows and surges raced downslope at a speed of more than 200 kilometers per hour, incinerating everything they touched. By the time three major blasts had occurred by the end of July 31, 1968, an area of 15 square kilometers had been devastated, including three local settlements which resulted in 87 fatalities. This was Costa Rica's deadliest volcanic eruption. The Arenal volcano would then produce a prolonged eruption across the next 42 years, creating a large lava field on its western flank and building a new cone just west of its summit that grew the volcano by 77 meters or 253 feet. That eruption ended in 2010, marking one of the world's single longest continuous eruptions in recorded history. Yet, despite the destruction and deaths it caused in 1968, this eruption never reached beyond a volcanic explosivity index of a 3. For reference, Arenal has been the fifth most consistently highly explosive volcano during the Holocene, with the vast majority of its Holocene eruptions rating on the volcanic explosivity index as a 4, marking activity an order of magnitude more severe than what was witnessed in 1968. It is for this reason that special attention is given to this complex due to its highly explosive eruptions, although it hasn't shown any signs of life since it stopped erupting in 2010. For reference, the Arenal volcano can be found in the north-central portion of Costa Rica, where it is 6 kilometers west of the town of La Fortuna. The Arenal volcano exists in the southern portion of the Central American volcanic arc, with the southerly portion existing due to the offshore subduction to the southwest of the Cocos Plate underneath the Panama microplate. Partial melting then occurs on the subducted crust, rising upwards into the overlying crust to form a chain of volcanoes. The age of the Arenal volcano seems like a simple thing to explain, but the truth is it depends on what you consider to be the extent of the Arenal volcano. As 2,700 meters south-southeast of Arenal's summit is another notable volcanic cone known as Cerro Chato. Cerro Chato was intermittently active between 38,000 and 3,800 years ago, producing numerous explosive eruptions that emplaced overlapping layers of basaltic andesite and andesite lava and ash. Early eruptions emplaced primarily basaltic andesite, while later eruptions emplaced distinctively low silica andesite lava domes that are today called Chatito and Espina. The Arenal cone did not exist until its first eruption in 5060 BCE, and this eruption was a highly explosive Plinian eruption that devastated the surrounding landscape. Several centuries later, what was at the time a raised volcanic crater in the ground erupted again, albeit only in a moderately explosive Strombolian manner, allowing multiple basaltic andesite lava flows to begin constructing its main volcanic cone. Eruptions continue to be infrequent, occurring at a rate of once every 500 years for the next 3,000 years, involving four total Plinian eruptions. Cerro Chato produced its last two eruptions during this time span, specifically in 3300 BCE and 1750 BCE. After Chato became inactive, eruptions at Arenal became more frequent and explosive, averaging about once every 200 years in the time since. 14 Plinian eruptions have occurred since, rapidly building the volcano to its modern height, with these larger eruptions generally occurring in clusters of at least 3 across 200 to 400-year-long time spans, only to be followed by 270 to 870 years of no activity or only less explosive activity occurring. With the last cluster of 3 Plinian eruptions occurring between 1020 and 1400, we are currently in another such less explosive period. Overall, Arenal's edifice currently has a volume of around 7.9 cubic kilometers, being composed of 60% ash, tephra, and pyroclastic flow and surge deposits, and 40% lava rock. I do want to note that rarely eruptions at Arenal can be completely effusive, such as one during the mid-18th century that produced a series of basaltic andesite lava flows. While the current topography of Arenal will largely send its main hazards during eruptions to the west, this does not mean that other sectors, including to the east, are not at risk. Future eruptions can hypothetically inundate all surrounding sectors and lava flows and pyroclastic flow and surge deposits, and major explosions can send large lava bombs and volcanic blocks a similar distance.